Welcome to the second part of my documentary of Vietnam.
Is all I want to give to you. Love is more.
This is a bar in Hanoi where expats hang out. A lot of tourists come to Vietnam. Mainly Europeans who travel the whole of Southeast Asia. You find that a lot of bars, cafes, and restaurants will cater for the tourists. I was in the capital Hanoi for a couple of days before heading out to Ho Chi Minh. To get to Ho Chi Minh, I'll be traveling by bus and plane, passing through the cities of Hue and Da Nang and the coastal town of Hoi An. The first leg of my journey is from Hanoi to Hue. I took an overnight sleeper bus, and this was a first-time experience for me. In Vietnam, most people use motorbikes, as it is very expensive to run and own a car. Vietnam has an overall population of 95 million and has over 45 million registered motorbikes. To me, I found it very interesting as well as strange how everything is done on the motorbike. Coming from Ireland, where the health and safety regulations are very strict, I found it very strange and impressive to see children on the motorbikes. Nothing is impossible to carry on the motorbike in Vietnam. Everybody seems to be moving to the same rhythm. There is a method to the madness, which only the Vietnamese can understand. Vietnam is a one-party state led by the Communist Party of Vietnam. They have been the ruling party in North Vietnam from 1954. And they seized power in South Vietnam in 1975, combining the two separate states after winning the Vietnam War. After 15 hours on the bus, we arrived in Hue City.
How much?
50 million.
Oh, how much Vietnam do you
A lot.
I was approached by this man who collects souvenirs from passing tourists.
I collect.
Who give this to you?
Internet souvenir.
He had a $50 million bond note from Zimbabwe.
11 years.
Oh, he gave you? Oh, 11 years ago.
Yeah.
Was he from, he was from Zimbabwe, yeah?
Zimbabwe, I told it in stop in souvenir.
For where's that one for Ireland?
Ireland, Ireland, here I have.
That's Northern, yeah, that's Northern Ireland.
Yeah.
That's Northern Ireland, no, yeah. South Island.
You have island again, you see?
island.
Yet I can see bright sun coming up.
Island. After spending a couple of hours in Hua City, I decided to carry on to Da Nang, which is the biggest city. At the bus stop, I came across these locals playing cards. In Zimbabwe, we would call them Mawindi. They get a commission for picking up tourists and loading them onto the buses. They play card games for money while waiting for the bus. In Zimbabwe, we call it Juga. After another couple of hours on the bus, I arrived in Da Nang City. I decided to stay in a hostel because this is the best way to meet other people. Da Nang is an important port city for Vietnam and is the fifth largest in the country. While walking the streets of Da Nang, I came across this group of men playing this board game. It seems like an everyday occurrence, with the men enjoying challenging each other. Da Nang is a beautiful city that is split into two by the Han River. The two parts of the city are connected by the Dragon Bridge. The bridge is 666 meters long and has six lanes for traffic. Construction of the bridge began in July of 2009 and it was completed and officially opened on the 29th of March 2013. We are currently headed to the east side of the city. There is a lot of construction happening on this side of the city, with hotels and casinos being built. Other tourist attractions in Da Nang include the Lady Buddha, Marble Mountain, and the beautiful beaches. Through my guide Sun, I managed to visit all three places, starting with the Lady Buddha.
To come back to the top Marble Mountain.
Oh, that's where we're going. Is that where we're going to eat?
Yeah.
In Marble Mountain, yeah?
Marble Mountain, eat very nice.
Very nice food, yeah.
You eat your walking around here at Marble Mountain.
Okay. Yeah, looking forward to it. Yeah. I should have come here yesterday.
Yeah.
It's a pity. Yeah, this is nice. So this is Da Nang anyway. It's a rapidly going city slash town. I say now it's kind of like a city. It was a fishing village like maybe 12 to 15 years ago. But now, so I'm with my guides Sun, and he's gonna take me to Hoi An, which is like 40 minutes from here. So I decided to take a bike ride, get the whole experience. Yeah, but I missed this side because Da Nang is split into two. I was on the other side of Da Nang, that side, and I was actually advised to come in this side yesterday, but I didn't because I was drinking. Yeah, now I don't get to really see this side, but it's okay because Hoi An actually has better beaches than here, so I'm gonna do the whole beach thing there. So anyways, let me just take in the picture. He's taking me to some Buddha, some monk statue up the hill here. So yeah, we took a pit stop. So guys, yeah, loving it. Yeah. Wow.
Love it.
The Lady Buddha is the tallest Buddha statue in Vietnam. A lot of visitors come and visit its temple. My guide Sun then took me to the beach.
Hello from Da Nang. So I'm in Da Nang. Just on the side of the beach. I was just up there at the Lady Buddha. That's just where I was up there. So now we've come back to the city and we're just by the seafront. Yeah, it looks really, really good. And you know, quite a few people out. You know, it's just, you have to time your seasons right, because right now it is actually very, very hot and humid. I mean, it's even hot for me, but it's not as hot as Hanoi. But not knowing how, if the water is cool or not, let me go see actually. Right now it's like 25 past 12, so I guess the sun is kind of still, you know, still to peak, so I guess people will come out. Foreigners are out, but still, Jesus, the air being hot. This guy here is having a good time anyway. Quick tan. Oh, it's quite nice actually. Oh yeah, I like that. As per usual, everyone is covered up because they don't like the sun. They actually don't want to tan. And I'm actually wearing my helmet from the motorbike, so everyone's kind of looking at me like, what the frrrr? But yeah, the water's nice. I can see Da Nang being a big tourist. Well, not more than it already is, but like it's still a city that's growing. You know, it's really booming, and like building after building is coming up. You know, building after building, hotels, especially on the seafront, restaurants. So I can see Vietnam competing with Thailand. Never been to Thailand. But Vietnamese people are nice, so they, you know, they'll make you come here, come back. You know, I don't know about Thai people, but I'm sure they're nice as well. So yeah, let's go see what Hoi An has to offer. I'll go swimming then, you know, but that feels good, yeah. So let me go for one more dip. Oh, yes. In with the knees, yes, yeah. Bantu style. Right, I'm out.
After a couple of days in Da Nang, it was time to hit the road again. I was heading to the next town, Hoi An, a beach resort town 29 kilometers away. We stopped to see Marble Mountain on the way. It is made from marble and limestone. I definitely felt the peace and the calm in these mountains. My guide Sun then took me to a nice hotel in Hoi An as we parted ways. Hoi An can be found in Quang Nam province and was declared a World Heritage Site by UNESCO in 1999. With an increased number of tourists visiting, a variety of activities are available. I managed to go parasailing and jet skiing.
Hello guys. I'm in Hoi An. Arrived yesterday. I'm here for 2 days, so today is my last night. Did a few things last night, and today I decided to go to the beach, so I wanted to check out my view. Yeah, so we're in the water. But yeah, I love it. Yeah, jet skiing was great. Like, I've never done it, something like that before, but the thing just balances so well on top of the water. It's just like riding a bike, actually. Wasn't too scary like I thought it would be, but yeah, I loved it. And I was in the water after that. I think I was swimming in the water for like, I don't know, 3 hours. Like, right now I'm gassed. I'm just really tired, and just had a smoothie, some water. So yeah, tonight's my last night, and then I'm gonna fly from Da Nang to Ho Chi Minh tomorrow. And yeah, my last chapter is in Ho Chi Minh. Hopefully I get to see a lot of stuff in Ho Chi Minh. And I heard it's different from Hanoi. More people, more younger crowd, more motorcycles, more busy. So, but the War Museum is there, the Vietnam, the tunnels where they fought the war, they're there. The Mekong River is there. Hopefully I get to do those three things in whatever time I have left. So I've enjoyed it. I have enjoyed my time. So guys, I'll talk to you soon. Bye. On my last night in Hoi An, I came across an Irish bar. That's gone.
Do you have a fresh dog?
That's not gonna light up. The majority of people that were in the nightclubs were tourists. I had a great time in Hoi An and would recommend it to anyone coming to Vietnam. But he who trusts in the Most High, by his steps Jah will always abide. Jah Jah love it surround me evermore. This my prayer every time I rise. Yeah, Lord, give me serenity to accept the things I can't change, and the courage to change the things I can. My time was up and it was time to fly to Ho Chi Minh City, previously known as Saigon. Ho Chi Minh City is the financial and economic center of Vietnam.
It was full, you know?
Oh.
Yeah, it was full.
In 1976, the government of a unified Vietnam renamed Saigon to its current official name in honor of the communist leader, Ho Chi Minh.
Lab, I will
pay
for you.
If what?
I think it's in class, I will pay for you.
Okay.
To go to school.
All right.
name of this street again?
Huh?
What's the name of that street again?
Zimbabwean. Zimbabwean.
Zimbabwean.
B-U-I.
Yeah.
B-I.
Zimbabwean.
Yeah.
Oh, that's the famous one, yeah?
Yeah. Okay, so what is your hotel? I don't know. Okay.
Ho Chi Minh is very busy, so to get around, I got some assistance from my new friends, Yin and Tuan. What are the chances?
Coincidence.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Yes. They took me to see the War Museum and the Independence Palace. The Independence Palace is the former house of the President of South Vietnam, who was defeated in 1975 after the Vietnamese War. Yes. So what time, what bus are you going to get? What time?
Anytime.
Huh?
Anytime.
Anytime, yeah? All right. Safe home. See you on WhatsApp.
Okay.
All right. Thank you, Yin and Tuan, for showing me around the city. The Cricket World Cup was happening at this time. England was playing New Zealand in the final.
The English balcony can hardly look. Here's Nation again. Just the single. Just the single, fellas. Can't go, can't go. They don't have to throw. Dotson good, Dotson good.
I was in Ho Chi Minh for 4 days and I managed to do quite a lot. I got a new tattoo and I tried out all the local food that was suggested to me. My time in Vietnam was coming to an end. This was my first time in Asia. Everything was strange and fascinating at the same time. I had to adjust and adapt to the situation, especially when it came to crossing the roads. There are very few black people in Vietnam. It was even difficult to get a barber who could do afro hair. It was the first time for this barber and I had to direct him. I had strangers coming up to me asking for a picture.
Freaking place is packed now. How are you? Ching Tao? Yeah, the only black man inside. She wants a picture. She's run away.
My time in Vietnam has come to an end. I have great memories and I'm happy with the connections that I made. Thank you for watching my documentary. Don't forget to like, share, and press the red subscribe button at the bottom to get more videos from me. Thank you very much. This is my king's speech, I'm nowhere near the end. If I was supposed to start, sorry I ain't heaven sent. I messed my life up, and yeah I've been down. I'm a changed man now, Chris Brown. You know I feel your pain, cause I done been through it. I'm Kurt Cobain, but I just couldn't do it. No point in turning back, just to hit rewind. Back to the future, Marty McFly. Deep inside there's a fire, cause I'm no longer looking at a reflection that I admire. I paint a picture of a fighter, but that's someone looking back at me says I'm a liar.
should die before a wave.